And my dear teachers, this is Bhavesh Kumar, STNC of the school. I would like to invite Mr. Nirudh Sarkar, who is PGT in our school. This training system is our new education policy. So please welcome Mr. Nirudh Sarkar for in-house training. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir, for giving me a golden opportunity. Good afternoon, Principal sir, and my all dear colleagues. I have been asked to deliver a lecture on new education policy and its consequences on the education. Before getting into the NEP, I would like to create a background in the concept of new education policy. What is education? At first, when we think about education, there is a big question: what is education? So, first of all, what is the definition of education? How do we define education? Everyone has its own idea about education. Everyone has its own perspectives towards education. What he feels. But according to Wikipedia, when we get stuck to find any answer or question, we will go towards Google and Wikipedia say answer. And according to Wikipedia, education is the process of facilitating learning on the acquisition of knowledge, skill, values, morals, beliefs, habits, and personal development. It is according to Wikipedia, but everyone has its own perspectives about education. So I guess all of you are somehow aware of this definition. All of you, I think. The meaning of education is very subjective according to Wikipedia, but everyone can have their own perspective or interpretation of the word education. But I would like to go to one step ahead and would like to define education to the word of Swami Vivekananda. What does he say about education? What is his perspective towards education? So, I would like to go one step ahead. That's why, because Swami Vivekananda has its own perspective. And that is, according to Swami Vivekananda, the education is the process by which character is formed. The main purpose of education is forming character. So he says, the process by which character is formed, strength of mind increases and intellect is sharpened, as a result of which one can stand on one's own feet. Means, if he is educated, then it means he has to stand his own feet. So, according to Vivekananda, do we think, we believe that he is right? Most of say yes, Vivekananda is right. His perspective is very, very true according to scenario. So, some might say yes, some might say no, and even some would stand somewhere between these two notations, yes or no. It is not possible everyone think a single thing. That thinks by Vivekananda. But what I have experienced in my short career of teaching, that is important. What I have experienced. So education is very different than the view of Swami Vivekananda. Education has now become all about scoring marks. Nothing more. Education is now become all about scoring marks, cracking competitive exams, role learning, and getting a high paid job. The aim of education is now just scoring marks by any means and earn money. Nothing else. Just get marks and earn money. Nothing else. We don't imbue students with the ideas. We don't allow them to think. We don't allow them to think. We don't allow them to something do out of box, out of range, out of clarity. We don't let them follow their passion too. We can't allow them to follow their passion. We tend to underestimate humanities. Parents ask students to study math, science, engineering, medical, law. That's why, because they all are high paid sectors and well sectors. That's why parents enforce their child to you must have to read math, science, engineering, medical, etc. But earning, yeah, it is important to earn money. It is very true. It is important to earn money, but earning a lot of money is not the only important thing. I repeat it, yeah, it is important to earn money. It's very true. But earning a lot of money is not the only important thing. What is the relevance of education? If you can't think independently about any issues, what is going on in the country? Education helps you to form a perspective. It helps you to discover ideas. But our ideas imbue and get one direction. That is only getting marks and get maximum amount, maximum money. Nothing else. So recently I come across US World University ranking. Recently, in 2022, there is only 3 Indian universities in top 20. Sorry, top 200. There is only 3 Indian universities in top 200. In US World ranking, the universities are IIT Bombay at 177th position, IIT Delhi at 185th position, and IIT Bangalore is 186th position. And not surprisingly, there is not even a single university of India is top 100 US university ranking. Single, even a single university, not in top 100 universities. We often tend to compare India with China. Somehow, when there is some scenario, we feel that most of the person always try to compare between comparison between India and China. There are 24 universities of China in top 200 US world ranking in 2022. 24. In India, there is only 3. But in China, there are 24 universities which is in top 200 US ranking. It's not that the Indians are not talented. But it's not mean that we are not talented. We Indians are have lots of talents, but it is just a mindset that needs to be changed. All things happen due to mindset. Okay? And we need to pay a bit of attention of the definition of education on the word of Swamiji. What did he say? What is his perspective? In our education, focus more on the character building, sharpening intellect, we can become the ego. Means we have to build a character through education, not to build a machine to earn money. We build student, not student, just a machine who can crack competition and earn lots of money. Now, I would like to touch a bigger condition in India, disparity between rural and urban children. This year we celebrating 75th year of independence. We have progressed a lot of these 75 years. Yes, we have progressed. In 1947, do you know what is the human literacy rate? In 1947, only 9% female are literate in India. Whereas male, in the perspective of male, there are 27% males are literate. On that time, I am talking about 1947, when we will get independence. As per 2011 census data, the female literacy rate was 65% according to 2011, and male literacy rate was 82%. These data are 2011. Now we are in 2022. The number will be high, obviously, after 11 years. Number must be higher. So, however, the educational outcomes in India is questionable. We are not satisfied. It must be questionable. In 2019, annual status of educational report was published by NGO, that is Pratham. ASER surveyor visited almost 37,000 children between 4 years to 8 years in rural district, access 24 states. According to that report, only 16% children class 1 can read text in the prescribed level. Only 16% children can read the text which is prescribed by Government of India, which is prescribed by NCERT. Only 16%. While almost 40% cannot even recognize letter, which one is A, which one is B, which one is C. They are unable to recognize that letter. And only 45% of children could recognize two digits number. Only 45% student of standard 1 can recognize that the letter is 29, 34, two digit letter. Further, global research shows that 90% of brain growth occurs by age 5. Yeah, it's very true. 90% brain growth occurs by age 5, meaning that the quality of early childhood education has crucial impact on the development and long-term schooling of a child. It means basic education is very, very, very important. Because 90% development has gone. Just now, the private school performing better than the government school according to ASPRO. Yeah, it's very true. This report also has a very important observation regarding age. The report found that a classroom could include a student from a range of age group. Skewing towards younger children in government school, more than a quarter of class 1 student in government school students are only 4 or 5 years old, younger than recommended age. These younger children struggle more than other in all skills. Of course, when students are not eligible for that class and he is in that class, they must suffer 100%. And it's happened usually, even most of the government schools. Problem is not only primary education. The condition of secondary and even higher secondary is worse. The new education policy was out for a long time after 32 years. India adopted a new education policy. It seems to be a positive change, at least on the paper. Now let's discuss some of the positives of new education policy. The number one is multilingualism of power of language. Willingly or unwillingly, we Indians are imbued with the mindset that if a particular student is able to speak, write and construct sophisticated English, then he or she is a competent, otherwise incompetent. Yeah, it's very true. If we often see in our society, if somebody is very fluent in English, then he is really a man of letters, he is a scholar. But if he has a lot of knowledge in Hindi, in sociology, in mathematics, in physics, but he is unable to speak fluent English, then he is not an educated person. It is a mindset in our society that is very, very, very worse mindset. If someone is not able to speak in English, that means not he is not an educated person. But right now it's happened in our society. The new education policy has put a full stop on that mindset. English is just a language like Hindi, Marathi, Telugu, Bengali, etc. It is great to have a command over your language, be it English, Hindi or whatever. It is very good. If you know English, it is very good. But if you don't know English, it means it can't say that. It can't refer that you are not a literate person. Simply. So, now the new education policy just remove and reject that thing. Wants to reject that thing. The new education policy has advocated that till 5th standard students should be instructed in their regional language. Either it is in English, Hindi, Marathi, Awadhi, etc. Up to standard 5th. It will help the student to comprehend the concept in better way. In my perspective, as far as I could think and apply my limited knowledge and wisdom, it is a laudable step and it must be welcomed. Really, it's a laudable step which is taken by project government. Focus on concept building rather than rote learning. Rote learning. Few years ago, movie has been come in our coming front of us, that is 3 Idiots. And what we observe that in that movie, we observe that there is no need to take your opinions, no need to take your own personal